Hello, it's Tanya Gabrielle, wealth astronomologist, and I'm so thrilled to bring you the new moon forecast for Taurus happening May 15th at 12:48 p.m. in London, 7:48 a.m. New York, and 4:48 a.m. in LA. Now, this new moon is so unbelievably fantastic. It happens on the 15th, as I said. That is the number of spiritual alchemy, of magic, of uplifting others through love. It's a number of abundance, romance. It's such a beautiful number because it governs alchemy. And the sun and moon will be at 24 degrees. Now, 24 and 15 both add up to the root number of 6, the number of love and family. So this so ties into Taurus too, because Taurus is a very sensual number. It's governed by Venus, the planet of love, the planet of abundance. So just all those factors together already make this a really special new moon. Now, 24 and 15 combined means that alchemy and love will be coming into your life. And when you dedicate yourself to everything you do by coming from the heart, by listening and not ignoring what your soul is speaking through your heart, listening to your intuition, that's when the alchemy, that's when the magic happens. And so this new moon is going to really accelerate and magnify your ability to create magic when you tune in on that level. And then obviously a lot of healing can occur as well. The number 15 and the number 24 reduced to 6, which also governs healing and health. So through love, through harmony, through peace, through compassion, those are all related to these numbers, right? That compassion for yourself, compassion for others, sensuality. Taurus is also so sensual. It's an earth sign. It wants you to discover your soul through actual physical nourishment. And so what makes this new moon even more exciting is that on the same day, May 15th, the planet Uranus, which has been in Aries for the past 8 years, is actually moving into the sign of Taurus. And this is a Taurus new moon. So they coincide, which is so synchronistic. I mean, Uranus could have chosen any day of the year to move into Taurus, and it chooses the Taurus new moon, new beginnings. So what this means is that Taurus is even more emphasized because Uranus is not only going into that sign now for the next 7 years, but it's doing it on the new moon. So anything to do with security, with financial abundance, because Taurus rules the second house in astrology. That's all about money coming to you and how you look at wealth, how you look at money, what it means to you, how you create financial flow in your life. What is your relationship to money? Is it a healthy one? Is it positive? Do you see money as a tool as opposed to something negative? Have you grown up thinking of money as evil or whatever it is that, you know, the unconscious paradigm that is running that narrative about money can be very complex, just like sexuality. And so it's very important during this time, and Uranus is in the sign for the next 7 years, to have a very healthy, free relationship with financial flow. And that's very exciting because, you know, when you think about freedom and you think about money, a lot of people are enslaved. They earn money because they have to, or they're in a job because they have to be in that job to take care of their own needs or their family's needs. And Uranus is saying, no, for the next 7 years, you're going to discover a new way to create financial flow. You're going to break free. You're going to, you know, basically break through. That's what Uranus is about. Break through the old paradigms and accept a new way of embracing wealth. And you're going to do this by accepting multidimensional reality. Uranus governs anything to do with genius and going out of the box, going into other realms. You know, it's sort of the Nikola Tesla planet. So exploring galactic realms, exploring another way to do things, creating new values. Taurus rules values, especially in love, abundance, beauty, right? Those basic qualities that we have to resonate with. So it's a powerful theme, this theme. And basically, we're going to create a much bigger, more healthy, free impact on our lives and other people's lives by really tuning into our true values. What do we value most? What is actually behind all our unconscious desires? What is it? Is it love? You know, is that really what it comes down to? Is feeling love and peace in your life and joy, right? Those are the values you want to always ask questions about when you're making decisions. And when Uranus is in Taurus, you're making decisions about these topics, right? Now, the new moon is always about new beginnings. And we're in an 11 universal year in 2018, which is the number one twice, double one. It's the portal, walking through the portal into new beginnings. So you're experiencing major new shifts anyway this year. So this moment of Uranus moving into Taurus the same day as the Taurus new moon is one of those pivotal moments during the year where you're going to feel some shift internally. So don't be surprised if there is some, you know, unexpected stuff that happens in your life or some changes that come up. Also, Uranus rules communication and electricity. It's powerfully connected to how you speak to others, how you integrate breakthroughs, how you are in the moment when things happen and, you know, they're unprepared and you just have to tune into your intuition. It governs intuitive downloads, your psychic intuitive lightning strike, you know, aha moments. And so, you know, this is it's just a really exciting time. And so, the other thing during this new moon that's important to note is that the sun and moon are forming a trine, a very powerful trine that's 120 degrees to both Mars and Pluto, which is going to bring you so much energy. So this means you're going to be much more determined to achieve your goals, to set your intentions, do so in a unique way. Remember, Uranus is involved in everything about Uranus is unique and new and different. And so you want to use your creative urges to consciously look for successful outcomes to your goals, like literally put them into practice. Remember, Taurus is an earth sign. It wants to get things grounded into earth, you know, really to bring things into physical reality. Now, your courage and ambition with Pluto and Mars forming this trine to the new moon is going to be magnified with this trine. So it's exciting too, because Mars and Pluto are in Capricorn, and Capricorn naturally governs career for us and is an earth sign too, like Taurus. So you want to really, you know, be very conscious about what you're focusing on, because it will actually manifest, especially in that sort of career environment. Now, the sun and moon are also opposite Jupiter during this new moon, and that's always exciting because Jupiter governs joy and expansion and wisdom, learning new things, you know, higher education. So the ultimate expression of Jupiter is joy through divine wisdom. And surrendering to that wisdom is what will bring your life into balance. When we have oppositions in astrology, there's something that needs to be brought into balance, right? So something feels out of balance in your life, or the flow isn't quite, you know, going in a way that without obstacles, let's just say that. If there's something in your life that feels like there's some boulders in the way, then this is your time to just listen, find the joy in what it originally was that you were looking for, and bring that into balance, whatever that takes, right? So another exciting aspect is that Jupiter is trine to Neptune during this new moon, and that brings long-term good fortune, longevity. You know, Neptune is really all about reaching everywhere, touching everything. It's the watery planet. So when it comes together with Jupiter in this way, it brings financial windfalls, deep spiritual fulfillment, it enhances your creativity and your imagination, it brings overall enrichment, and it enhances your psychic awareness. So it's super fortunate, and it happens right during this new moon. And then Mercury has come around, is in early Taurus, right next to Uranus, which has just moved into Taurus, and it is squaring, both of them are squaring Mars. Now, this is a really major activation. Any square activates you. It tells you to get up and get something done. And if you don't, you will feel irritated, especially with this square with Uranus and Mars. So there's a lot of excitement around this square. There's restlessness as well. Your mind will be really activated because Mercury governs the mind, and Uranus and Mercury both govern communication and ideas. And, you know, Uranus ideas are like genius ideas. Mercury wants you to connect, to write things down, to speak your message. And so you have to really listen, because these ideas will awaken something very deep inside of you. So be conscious if you notice some new perceptions, definitely go and create something. If you don't, you will feel nervous, irritable, restless. So the whole point of this square is to focus on what breakthroughs, what changes, you know, need to come into your life in order to fire you up, make use of that energy by doing something that feels like it's lighting your inner fire. So those are really powerful breakthroughs that are awaiting you with this Taurus new moon, and with Uranus moving into Taurus the same day. It really is extraordinary. It's exciting. It's amazing. I'm just so in love with this new moon, and I hope you have a fabulous Taurus new moon experience. So enjoy your amazing Taurus new moon experience, and I will see you soon for the Sagittarius full moon. Bye-bye for now.